Hey guys, Sav here, back with some more Living Story Season 3. This is Episode 4, Head of the Snake. The very first part of this I have done before, the rest of it I have not, so everything else will be a fresh take on it. The first one, I just wanted to get in and see the new map, so I kind of went ahead and did it on another character, so I get into the new map. So it won't be completely fresh like it was the last time or two that I did this, but this time it'll just be the first chapter that is not. Hopefully this is working. Okay, it's not. So we have to do that. Okay. Basically what happened, guys, I had some technical difficulties when I started recording here, so what I'm actually going to do is swap to another character and replay the first part for you guys. Because, long story, basically what had happened was I thought I was recording it. I went through and played through the first part, or not really played, but listened to it. You'll see in just a second here. And yeah, I wasn't recording, so I had to start over again. So we're going to start the chapter on my Necro here, and then we'll switch back to my Thief and actually do the story mission. So we get a mail from Queen Jenna.
An invitation from the Queen herself. Timmy, do you read me?
You can be under... Oh, I must have nodded off there for a second.
I'm headed to Divinity's Reach to meet the Queen, but... Have you heard from Bram?
No, sorry. Rox got word through, though. Apparently she talked some sense into him. He formed an exploratory committee, let's say. They're making their way up to Jormag as we speak, to see what kind of damage they can do before mobilizing a larger force. I'm worried about him, Commander. He's calling this group Destiny's Edge.
I don't suppose Ritlock or Kaith had any say in that.
No. I don't want to lose him to Jormag. And if we're right about its weakness, he won't stand a chance.
How are we doing on that front?
I have an idea. A great idea. Well, brilliant, really. But I need to complete the experiment with the samples, then reach out to some contacts to see if I can get what I need for the aforementioned brilliant idea. I'll keep you posted. Anyway, say hi to the Queen for me.
Do you know her?
I feel like I do, after all the gossip rags I've read. Do you know she doesn't wear shoes? Try not to stare at her feet now that I told you that.
You're a huge help, as always. Get some rest.
Oddly enough, no mention of Zoja or Logan in the Destiny's Edge discussion there. Alright, switch back to my Thief. And we will head to Divinity's Reach.
Illustrious leader of Dragon's Watch. Welcome.
I appreciate the sentiment, Your Majesty, but I feel like I haven't been much of a leader lately. I don't know how you do it. You have a whole kingdom to worry about while I can't even manage to keep a handful of people driving toward one purpose.
It's a trying task, but to be honest, sometimes I envy what must be the simplicity of your life. This place is all politics and subtext. Do a thing one person likes and three hate you for it. It can get very complicated. You just relentlessly smash things until they're no longer at odds with you. I wish it were like that around here sometimes.
Yeah, that's all I do, just smash things.
Well, what can I smash for you today?
I believe a White Mantle attack is imminent, and must take certain actions here in Divinity's Reach to ensure its safety.
The fact that you're not really describing these actions makes me think they might be a little unorthodox.
What do you think of this garden, Commander?
It's lovely.
Isn't it? And to preserve such a marvel requires constant maintenance. Sometimes weeds creep in, and sometimes you must eradicate them, lest your garden become unkempt.
I see.
I've called the ministers here under the auspices of a reassuring gathering, but I really need to deliver what some will consider shocking news. Your presence here will go a long way to ease minds, so please, mingle. And also, keep an eye out. Any evidence of White Mantle meddlings you find would only support my actions.
I'll do some digging. And Your Majesty, you missed a weed here.
That looks like one, but it's actually the Crichton spiderwort. It'll bloom soon, and its petals give you the most luscious dyes. It's my favorite flower. It hides its true potential from most, and then blossoms into something great. Happy hunting, Commander.
Is there something else you need, Commander? I'm surprised you invited me here instead of Anise. Where is she? Anise is occupied, I'm afraid. In other words, her voice actor probably wasn't available. As for... I'm sorry, I'm jaded. As for your invitation, you're a trusted friend, and I have no doubts your presence is a welcome relief to the ministers as well, the loyal ones anyway. I have more questions. Do you have any updates on Logan Thackeray? I'm sad to say that Logan is still recovering from his injuries. There isn't much else I'm able to tell you about his recovery, but it has been slow. Since Claudicus was in charge of the Minister Guard, are you concerned about their loyalty? I most certainly am concerned, Commander. It's why I need you here. Alright. See, there's several green stars on the map here. We'll go around and start talking to everybody. Like this bitch. Excuse me, I couldn't help notice you speaking with the Queen. How is she? A pillar of strength under pressure as always. Oh, that's good to hear. With everything that's happening, I worry for her, for us. Yes, the White Mantle are beyond despicable, aren't they? Quite. Power-hungry mongrels with nothing more than gold in their eyes. Indeed. I stepped on things with more moral authority than those poisonous toads. It's very clear how you feel about the White Mantle. Your friend Claudicus' association with them must have rattled you. I could tell you no one was more shocked. I hadn't the faintest idea. Really? Even with all the rumors circulating before he broke out? Oh, I try to ignore gossip. People caught spreading such filth should earn a trip to the gallows. I feel the same way about traitors. You should watch their necks. Good day. Mr. Estelle, if you guys don't remember, there was a story step in Living World Season 2 she's been out of the story so long I forgot her name. Casimir, with Lady Casimir, and you had to attend a party, and you had to basically somehow get her arrested, and because she's a White Mantle spy. let's not beat around the bush. I don't know if we knew it was White Mantle at the time, but... why, hello, Commander. Is there something you need? I'm just checking in. How do you feel about tonight's gathering? It is not wholly uncommon for the Queen to request a meeting, but given the circumstances, I am a bit concerned. What circumstances? Well, surely you're aware of the detestable betrayal of our own legate minister. He's been missing for some time, so I hear. I'm aware. Did you work closely with Claudicus? Claudicus and I only ever met in official capacity. Aside from spotting him at an occasional party, we rarely interacted. I see. Do you have any reason to suspect anyone has sympathies for him? I don't mean to spread gossip, but there was rumors that Minister Arton was colluding with the White Mantle prior to Claudicus' defection. As I understand it, he and the Legate are close friends. The Queen seems to trust Minister Arton, though. Why don't you? Well, I suppose a bad reputation can be difficult to overcome. That may be unfair of me, but I have a hard time trusting anyone during times like these. I understand. Thank you for your time. I didn't read this particular person last time, but there's this person right here, I believe, says the exact same thing. In fact, I'm going to test this theory right now.
I'm surprised the Wii family has the guts to show their faces.
I could talk to the Wiis, but I'm kind of curious about this. So we're going to find out. Okay. I guess the people moved around. That's all. Okay. I guess they move around at some point, because I spoke to somebody earlier that said that exact same thing. It wasn't that one in particular, but it had the same generic minister name, so I don't know. Maybe she moves.
Troubled times.
I think I can speak for the Shining Blade when I say I'm glad that you're here, Commander. I'm honored. Looks like you've got plenty of support from the Ministry Guard. Indeed, there are a lot of Ministry Guards here, but this is a meeting of the Ministry, so I suppose it makes sense. Still something about it has me on edge. On edge? How so? The Shining Blade takes an oath to protect the throne and Crito above all. The Ministry Guards, however, pledge their allegiance to the Legate Ministers, or Legate Minister, to Claudicus. Do you think any Ministry Guards still hold allegiance to that traitor? I have my suspicions. No proof, but I certainly have my suspicions. Have you seen any suspicious activity among the Ministry Guard recently? I haven't, but I'm not foolish to think that just because I don't see it, it's not there. The traitors are cunning, and we have to remain vigilant. Is there anyone that you're particularly suspicious of? I'd rather not point any fingers for false accusations. Suffice to say, I'm keeping an eye out. Anyway, I respect your decision, but I could really use your insight. Well, I'm surprised to see Estella's here. Is still a part of the ministry after she was caught lying about official matters. I know the Queen pardoned her, but... Well, I just can't trust her, not again. Good point, thanks for sharing the info. I'll keep an eye out.
That didn't sound
stupid
good.
Piece of junk. This is unbelievable. No, oh, bother, not again.
What happened? The white mantle?
Calm down. Third time this week this old guy's gone down. Ah, I have to manually enter manifest data when he's offline. Can you?
Your base.
Would you mind getting him up and running while I keep the gate's records?
Sure.
What a sport. And do be quick about it. My hand cramps easily.
This is an odd method of repair.
He can be a bit finicky, but the fix-it interface, or fixter face, I created, should make it clear what he needs in order to be fixed. Do you think that'll catch on? I was also toying with combining display and repair into disrepair. Oh. Never said that aloud.
I'm kind of working on it as we speak here. You'll see he gets cold, so you warm him up, and then he gets electrocuted. So you need to ground him with this one, and then he'll set on fire, so you need to cool him off. Pretty sure it's random every time. Pretty lame.
Dragon slaying, you should think about opening your own golem repair shop. No one came in or out, so I didn't end up needing to man the gate locks. Plus, I needed the break.
Glad I could do your job for you. By the way, I found this part, but didn't know where it went. Looks a little like...
I've never seen that before. I don't know what it is, but it's not part of this golem.
Huh. Hey, Timmy.
Hold on! Okay, I'm here.
Is the communication device you gave me one of a kind?
Probably not. I mean, mine is by far the best and most advanced, but there are others out there. Wait, why do you ask?
I found a device that looks a lot like the communicator. If it was planted here by the White Mantle, they could be listening in. I'm guessing it isn't the only one.
Oh, if you want, I can use your communicator to send out a high-frequency ping that'll help you find any others in your area.
Let's do that. I'll get what I can and show the Queen.
Oh, be sure to let her know I helped!
So you get this, communicator ping on your special action key, and you hit it. This little orb will appear. It lets you know I'm getting close. It's blue if you're nowhere near anything, yellow if you're getting closer, and red it'll actually show you where it's at. Which means you're really close. Anyway, let's talk to Arden here. How many of you have service commanders this evening? What are your thoughts on tonight's gathering of ministers? I can't help but feel a bit uneasy during these difficult times. I suspect the large number of guards present are the Queen's way of reassuring us ministers, but their presence has me anxious. What do you make of the extra security measures? The Queen always has our best interests in mind. Of this, I have no doubt. You speak highly of her. Are you too close? Her Majesty has guided me through the turmoil in the past and illuminated my harsh truths about traitors whom I once called friends. So she has my fullest confidence. Yeah, I guess they're kind of heading up. That's where the meeting's actually going to take place. I guess some are starting their way up there. I'm going to talk to the Wheeze before we continue looking for these communicator things here. What was all the commotion, commanders? Is everything all right? Everything is fine. The gate golem was acting up, that's all. I pity that golem's attendant. I don't envy his position. It is, however, good to see you at a time like this. Do you have reason to distrust anyone at this meeting? If people cross over, it could happen. It could be anyone. People you would never expect. Like your daughter? Yes, Valette made some horrible mistakes. Mistakes? Wow, two grammar. Come on, Annette. Get your grammar together here. We are devastated, as you can imagine, but our daughter's actions are not our own. Your association with Valette raises suspicions about your allegiances. The Queen has no reason to be concerned, and neither do you. My wife and I have always worked for the betterment of Krito. The way I'm gathering it so far is you talked to about three people before that gate crash thing happens. And they all say the same thing afterwards, except they'll ask you about what the crash was. And that's pretty much the only difference.
I could outrun a centaur.
Talk to Farron. Off to save the day again, Commander. How am I not surprised to see you running toward the source of an explosion? I have a knack for finding trouble. What brings you to this ministry meeting? Oh, he's my plus one. I didn't want to be the only minister to come without a guest. Plus, I like to keep some muscle around during these dangerous times. I see. I can never turn down a lady's invitation. Should the White Mantle dare to show their faces, Swordmaster Farron will put them in their place. Have you seen anything suspicious this evening? Thankfully, no, but I have been rather busy chatting with Minister Marula. That's nice. Oh, Farron, don't let me distract you all evening. I think I should get going. Lady Gwyneth. Speak with her. I heard the commotion. Is everything alright, Commander? Ah, yes. Nothing to worry about. Are you here on behalf of Minister Cauticus? I am. The people of Beetleton still need a voice within the Ministry, and I am committed to ensuring that we maintain good relations despite Cauticus's treason. You must have worked closely with Cauticus. For a time, yes. Since he converted to the White Mantle, he has abandoned us, so it has been a long time since I saw him. Do you and the people of the Shire still hold sympathies for him? Of course not. We are ashamed to have ever called him our leader. He has turned his back on Krita and on the gods themselves. Good to know. I guess you should focus on finding these so we can continue this. None of the ministers really say anything any more exciting than really what we've read so far. I know where one of them is, so I'm gonna find that one right now. It's up here. Not. Okay. It was blue, but there's clearly one right here. I guess it wants me to find them in order, maybe? I'm not sure. Coming up blue now. I don't know. I heard the explosion, Commander. Thank you for handling the situation. It was my pleasure. How can I help you, Commander? Have you seen anything suspicious? No, but we've been on high alert as of late. Our legate minister, Cauticus, converts the White Mantle, as you know, and that has reflected poorly on us. Do you suspect anyone among the guard to be sympathetic towards Cauticus? I have heard the ministry guards in the past have betrayed Krita, but now? Here at the gathering? No way, Commander. Our men are loyal to Queen Janna. That's why they are here. How can you be so sure? Honestly, I guess I can't be, but I promise to keep an eye out for anything suspicious. Mm-hmm. How is it blue just over there? Now it's bright over here. I don't know. Alright, and the last one was over. Nope. I guess I should go. Last one was. There's a bush, maybe? I don't remember.
Thank you.
like enough to back up whatever the Queen's about to do. I should give these to her.
Commander, I was just trying to reassure the Wees here. It's a stressful time for them. Well, not just them, for everyone.
The Queen is politely dancing around the fact that our daughter is on the wrong side of this.
Have you heard from her? At all?
We haven't heard from Valette. That doesn't mean we won't. She's a good girl, Commander. Just a little lost. She'll find her way home. We only want to hear her play the violin again.
We all do, Minister.
May we speak a moment, Your Majesty?
Of course.
Pardon us.
I found these listening devices around the courtyard. They could be White Mantle.
Thank you, Commander. I needed evidence like this to support my stance. It appears this is an opportune time, then. Allow me to excuse myself. I have a speech to give.
The plain faced guy from the trailer? There he is. Minister. He has no name. Oh, look who else is here. Yeah, we didn't see him. I have to talk to her? Where is she? Jenna? Oh.
Ministers and members of the royal court. For years, we've had a fester inside the kingdom. A creeping undertow that sucked some of our friends and family into its darkness. Now, with Confessor Codicus at the White Mantle's helm, this seething conflict will soon come to a head. As we are poised to be smashed between two rising elder dragons, we cannot stand for a threat from within. For this reason, I'm hereby suspending the ministry until the danger has passed. Some of you will understand it's for your safety. Others will understand that I have trapped them here. Far from the White Mantle's network.
You cannot! I won't be treated like a common doliac, herded into a pen and kept as livestock. I am no criminal. You claim this will keep us safe. From what? Who will keep us safe from you, I say?
Good minister, this measure is temporary, I assure you. Only until the kingdom is safe from attack and the traitors in our midst have revealed themselves. The commander has already
verified. There is no attack. This is an autocrat's ploy. Fellow ministers, this is a moment in life, a rare moment where you will look back one day and say, I made a stand or I did nothing. Do you silently let the Queen capture your voice and the voice of the people? Or do you make enough noise that the six gods themselves hear us say nay? When my grandfather...
Should I get that skill for raids, huh? I must have missed what happened to Art, and I guess I'll have to rewatch this video and see what happened. Because she screams, no, Minister Art, and I don't know, he doesn't seem to be anywhere to be found. Unless he became that jade. Pretty kind of strange.
Fury.
many contingencies. There are some defenses ready to set up right outside the chamber. Quickly! Cover me while I set up this defensive barrier.
I say when I see a Mesmer PvP. Not that I PvP anymore. Great, another Mesmer. The achievements yet. I don't know what the achievements entail for here, but I'm pretty much going to try to just ignore most of these guys and get everyone. But maybe there's an achievement for killing them all? I'm not sure. Watch? Holy shit, that's a watch knight. I didn't see this the first playthrough. Slay the Jade. Jade slaying watch knight. I kinda wanna see what Farron's doing. There he is, just standing there. Come on, Farron.
What is it?
I'm not sure. He's just gonna stand there. Got it. Okay. To the throne room. Plain-faced minister. That's it. That's all we got.
Ah, Jenna. That's enough. Fellow ministers, join me and help the White Mantle rid Kryta of this illegitimate ruler. Or stand by her side and be judged by my fire.
Estelle, what a surprise. Who could have seen this coming? You? Maybe you. Did you? And you, my friend? Were you surprised?
Get back here, you! I hate to break it to you, but I won't run as easily. I was honored when Cauticus tapped me for the job of regicide. And I will see it to its bloody end.
Not on my watch, Estelle.
Logan!
Captain Thackeray, beyond brave as always, but I need you leading the defense of the city. I'll handle this bloated tick.
Handle me? You can't move. This hamstrung doormat is your only hope, and I'm about to kill him just to put him out of his lovesick misery.
The stone.
What? The whole ministry knew it.
You'll regret that slight.
Damn you!
Oh. Wrapped up in something there. Look at Logan's doing there, huh? Ooh, what? Really? Bar.
That's the last of them, then. For now.
That was an impressive show, Your Majesty.
It was. How'd you like smashing things to solve your problems?
I never want to take up arms against one of my subjects, but I think I might be quite suited for your lifestyle.
I'll save you a spot in Dragon's Watch if you ever decide to step down.
Very kind. Now, what's the situation outside the city?
The White Mantle army is making a push from the lake, but we don't know the full extent of their numbers. I'm headed down to set up a command tent at Doric's Landing.
It's good to see you on your feet again. I'll meet you there.
Great. We could use the help. Talk to Lieutenant Fors in the Plaza of Lyssa. I'll make sure you're granted access to the battlefield.
Logan, please don't slow your recovery by doing something like getting yourself killed. Commander, thank you. And watch out for the weeds.
Right, that's the end of this chapter. We'll talk to Logan here real quick.
Shiny.
Not chapter, this part of the chapter. Thank you for protecting the Queen when I couldn't. I'm happy to help. How are you feeling? Recovery has been slow. The blooding pod changed me. Not my mind, but my body feels different. It's good to see you, Logan. I was worried. Don't worry about me, Commander. We have a war to fight. The White Mantle are pushing into Divinity's Reach from the east. Are there civilians that will need our aid? I can read. A great many of them, and all at the mercy of the White Mantle. They will need our full support. Then we should go at once. I'll see you soon. And then you can... Oh, I thought you could talk to him more. I guess not. I was kind of wondering if I could say anything to this guy.
May the Six watch over you.
Anyway. That'll be it for this part of the chapter, guys. I will see you next time for the second part of Living World Season 3, Chapter 4, The Head of the Snake. Thanks for watching.